Okay, so big tech stocks, when I say this, I'm talking stocks like Apple, Amazon, Microsoft, Google, Facebook. Heck, you can throw in Netflix, Nvidia, Salesforce, even if you will. These are massive, massive companies, a lot of them over $1 trillion market cap. However, the story is not over with them, guys. These stocks are still growing extremely well year over year. They're still extremely profitable. They still have extremely strong futures ahead. So why not consider them as investments? A lot of people say you've missed the boat on these stocks, but I'd beg to differ. And I've been talking about this both in my VIP group as well here on the YouTube channel for the last few months. About 2 months ago, I was discussing Facebook. This video didn't get a whole lot of views, but those of you that watched are probably benefiting massively right now because it was in the $260 range when I was talking about it. And I laid out my bull case in that video and why I believed this is a fairly easy 2x investment with very low risk. Since then, guys, the stock is closing in on close to 20% gains, somewhere around there. And despite the tech sell-off, despite the Nasdaq taking a big hit, despite all these high-growth stocks taking a big hit, the market volatility, Facebook is making new all-time highs now. And then, just a couple of weeks ago, I made a dedicated video on Amazon and explained in this video why this was yet another big tech name that was undervalued with, again, low risk but good upside. Amazon is only up a few percent since, but this needs time to play out. And a few percent in a couple of weeks, guys, is not too shabby though, so don't discredit this. And in my VIP group Discord, I've been explaining to my members for the last few months why these are such great value picks here with great upside, with great growth. And now we're starting to see the benefits of owning these names in our portfolio in 2020, despite what the broader market's doing. Now, I've personally been focusing on Facebook, Amazon, and Salesforce specifically, but a lot of others were finding value in things like Netflix or Microsoft or Google. And hey, these are all incredible companies. I own most of them here on this list. But anyways, the question comes up now. So since these stocks are moving higher, a lot of them pushing new all-time highs, is it too late now to buy into these stocks? Should we just kind of let it go? And if you didn't get in, you missed the boat, kind of, oh well, move on to the next investment? Not really. I think there's still, a lot more upside for these stocks. I think there's still a lot more to play out in terms of growth and capital appreciation in these companies. And that's what I kind of want to spend some time looking at today. I want to look at, how much do these companies plan to grow over the next year or so? What do their charts look like? Where can I see their stock going over time? And what do analysts think? Are analysts bullish on these companies? Are they bearish? This gives us a good sentiment as to what Wall Street believes the future holds for these businesses. And, if they're bullish, a lot of money flows in, which I did actually notice in the past few weeks with companies like Amazon and Facebook. So all I'll say is don't get fooled by these companies' massive market caps. There's a lot of gains to be made with these companies with low risk for your capital. And that's what really makes them such interesting investments here in 2021. Guys, take a second, hit the like button, share this with a friend as well, and subscribe if you're brand new to the channel. But regardless, let's jump into the details here. Okay, so I figured we'd start with kind of like the biggest, the baddest of the bunch here, Apple, $2 trillion market cap. What's going on with this stock? So this one is still down quite a bit from its highs. We go here, price range from the peak to the lowest point, it's been 20%, so that's a pretty good size correction. Today we're sitting at around 13-14%, off the highs. Still a good amount of upside here with this chart. We can see that we found support kind of at the 200 moving average, kind of hovering around these two 150-day moving averages. As soon as we break through, which we are showing signs of today, this thing's running back to all-time highs, guys. We may have a little bit of retracement and then go up, but this is a bullish sign for Apple here. In terms of what analysts have to say about this stock, they see around a 21% upside in Apple, $151, $152 price target. I think this is still kind of undercutting it. This will probably be in the high 100s by the end of the year, if not by the end of next year. So a lot of good upside here in the stock. Of course, one of the most stable companies you could ever own in your portfolio, the largest business in the entire world. So to see a nice 20% upside plus, can't really complain about that. Analysts here see around 21% growth in Apple, guys. Just think about that. They're gonna go from $274 billion in revenue to an estimated $333 billion in revenue this year, which is astronomical, like this is just astronomical numbers. And the next year we see things possibly will slow down, you know, 4.5% growth, still pushing close to $350 billion in revenue. So Apple, still a growth company, still doing well. We'll see how this turns out. I have a feeling that, you know, they're probably going to introduce new product, new service revenue stream. They're going to do something to kind of accelerate that to bring it back to double digits. And that's probably going to be the catalyst to move this much, much higher. Let's move on here. Let's go on to Facebook. This one's probably my favorite, one of my favorites here when it comes to big techs. This one made a new all-time high here today. It's just pushing higher. I made a call in our group. This will probably see 300 by the end of March. We got to, like, you know, pennies on that. We pretty much hit there, guys. But anyways, we hit April 1st, we broke 300, and now we're sitting at like 307, 308. So this one, again, strong technical setup, found support at the 200 moving averages, clearly moving higher, broke past the older 50, 100 moving averages. And yes, this is similar to what I think Apple could do, break past, retrace a little bit for another buying opportunity, and then just make a run higher. So Facebook's doing extremely well here. Jumping to what analysts have to say, now that we've already moved a little bit higher in the last few days, you know, around a 12% upside, still pretty good, $340 price target. I think some of the more bullish analysts here, like Jefferies, for example, 350, 385, 375, I think this stock could probably hit close to $400 by the end of next year. I'm not really sure if we're going to hit that by the end of this year. This year, 350 is definitely in the cards, but next year, I think around $400, not too far out of reach, which would give us some really, really nice upside on this stock. And you can see analysts have a strong buy consensus on this name. Now, if we jump over here, we can see what Facebook has in terms of their growth. This one's a monster. So if you tell me that Facebook's not a growth company, you're wrong. This one's growing 25% this year, 20% or so next year, breaking $100 billion in revenue this year for the first time is what's expected. You can see the next quarter is expected 45% growth. This quarter, 32% growth. Guys, this is a growth monster. Slowing down a little bit here, but all they have to do is just raise those ad rates just a tiny, tiny little bit, and boom, we're going to see massive growth, massive profits once again. You see, this business is just absolutely firing on all cylinders, and that's why Facebook is one of my favorite stocks, not only big tech, just in general in the entire stock market, guys. Moving on, let's go on to Amazon. Let's talk about Amazon here. So Amazon, we found good support here, nice double bottom created, almost picture perfect double bottom here in the stock. Found support at the 200. I was buying quite heavily around here, and now we're starting to move higher. We've broke past the previous resistance here on the 50 and 100 moving averages. We have clear skies ahead. I think this one is probably going to make a run for that $3,500 mark very, very soon. This one's been moving sideways for quite a while. Investors are getting frustrated, and that's typically when I think it's a good time to build your positions large in these companies, which is kind of what I've been doing in recent weeks as we dipped close to the $3,000 mark. I was like, this is just too good to be true, too cheap for a great business. I am buying. We jump over to what analysts here have to say about Amazon, guys. We can see in general, analysts are bullish. They see close to a 30% upside, a strong buy, over a $4,000 price target, which I think, again, is very doable for Amazon in the next 12 months. And you can see some of the more bullish analysts see like $4,250, $4,150. There's a lot of upside here that I think can be realized over the next year or so with Amazon stock. The one thing that's unanimous, though, is that everyone thinks this is a strong, strong buy. No one's a hold, no one's a sell, everyone's a buy. And that is a bullish, bullish sign on this stock. Amazon is another growth monster. Like, do not discredit this stock, okay? This one is expected to grow 22% this year, 17% next year. But look at this. Next year, they're going to pass over $500 billion in revenue. These are their profits, which are just exploding. This is their revenue estimate for next year. Guys, this one is another growth monster. Don't sit there and tell me this is not a growth stock. Don't sit there and tell me this is a boring company. This is an amazing business with an amazing future, amazing fundamentals, and as we saw, amazing upside potential. Moving on, talk about the other big tech, Microsoft, another one making new all-time highs today. This one actually held up really strong compared to the others. You see, we moved sideways for a bit like most of big tech, but then Microsoft at the beginning of this year just had a nice breakout here, and it's kind of been above this level ever since. It's kind of been the mover amongst the bunch, and it's been doing really, really well. Didn't dip below this 100 moving average, held it quite strong, and that shows us that there's a lot of buyers here at like the low 200s in Microsoft stock. We look at what analysts have to say. I don't suspect this is going to see too much upside, but we'll take a look here. Okay, around 12 to 15% upside, $280 price target. Some of the more bullish analysts see $300 plus. I think this is definitely going to be a $300 stock in the future. There's no question about that. How long it takes to get there? Maybe a couple of years or so. Doesn't grow as quick as some of the other companies, but again, similar to the others, strong buy. Everyone's a buy, no one's a hold, no one's a sell. This one has good upside potential. I just jump over here to Microsoft and take a look at what their growth looks like. 14.8% this year, 11% next year. You know, $164 billion this year, $182 billion next year. Good earnings right here. Everything's looking good. Things are trending in the right direction. Modest growth compared to some of the other big tech names like Facebook and Amazon specifically. But guys, still amazing growth. Microsoft is a profit machine, and Azure is just going to be one of their biggest profit makers over the long term. We're already starting to see the effects of that. We're already starting to see how much Amazon's making from AWS. Microsoft can do the same here with Azure. The last big tech name I would say is Google. And Google here is another one making new all-time highs today. Actually made new all-time highs a couple of days ago, just before the long weekend, kind of touched that all-time high. But now today we have clear confirmation, all-time high. This one's another one that's just kind of moved sideways for a little bit. But this has been one of the more undervalued plays amongst big tech, and a lot of people are starting to realize that now, which is why it's moving higher. And you can see this one kind of moves in a stepping stone, right? Move sideways for a bit, burst higher. Move sideways for a bit, burst higher. Move sideways for a bit, we're bursting higher. So we may have a period of consolidation once this hits, you know, a little bit of a higher price target. But over time, this is a clear winner, strong charts, and strong fundamentals. Google here, or Alphabet as the company is now called, is a strong buy, similar to the others, guys. Everyone's a buy. And this one shows a little bit of a lower upside, only around 8%. But I think that's kind of sandbagging it, if I'm being real honest. Google is another profit-driving machine, and this one should be valued higher. This one, you know, most people see it as like a 10% or so. We can see it's kind of mixed around the high, say around 8-9%, somewhere around 10-11%. That seems to be the general consensus here for more recent analysts that have done their analysis and updated things. 2500 seems to be a bit more bullish. I think long term, this is a $3,000 plus stock. There's no doubt about that. It may take time to play out because Google is one of those companies that faces regulation issues all the time, fines all the time. This constant quote unquote risk with this stock all the time, which is what holds it down, similar to Facebook. But over time, guys, you can't ignore the fundamentals. People are going to be buying in, and that's going to push these stocks higher. Now, in terms of what Google has in terms of growth, this is going to be another strong one, I have a feeling. Yep, there we go, 23.9% growth this year, 16% next year, probably get close to 20% is my guess with, you know, ad rates raising and more demand for advertisers online. And right now you can see they're pushing $200 billion in revenue. Next year going to be closer to $250 billion, $260 billion. Strong earnings continue to be expected in this stock as well. And yeah, all the metrics look extremely positive for this business. Now let's go kind of into like a few of the, not the five big tech names, the FANGs. Let's talk about a couple more of these other names that I really, really do like. Netflix, this one's been in the sideways movement that some of the other big tech has seen. Who knows, this may be the move where we actually start breaking higher. Netflix has been doing extremely well in terms of their fundamentals, and the stock price was just kind of too far ahead of fundamentals for a long time. But now things are turning around, investors are starting to see the value here, and this could be the temporary bottom, $500 or so for this stock. In terms of what analysts have to say about Netflix, There's a general consensus here of around $600 or so. That's around 14-15% upside. Some analysts a bit more bullish with a $700 price target, some a bit more bearish, but I think overall, this is still looking like a great business over the long term. So let's jump over here to what their growth is expected to look like this year and next year. Netflix, 20% growth this year, hitting $30 billion. Next year, 15%, hitting $35 billion or so. Very strong numbers again from this business. These pure play tech type companies are just going to see, you know, mass adoption, massive growth over the next few years. This decade is going to be kind of the golden decade for these businesses, in my opinion. And I think, you know, Netflix, while the short term may be a little bit shaky when they're spending all this money on content and kind of improving their platform, acquiring new customers, over the long term, their SaaS model is a winner. Now let's move on to another play that has been one of my best winners, guys. I've bought this stock. My cost base, I believe, is under 200 per share. So this is a really, really big winner for me. And I really, really do like the stock long term. Had a nice 25% correction recently. Been in this kind of box range for a little while. Found support at a very strong 200 moving average level. And in recent days, we're breaking higher. We're making a run for new all-time highs. In terms of analysts here, NVIDIA is a monster. Let me just say that. 16% upside, $650 price target. Some analysts are more bullish. I personally am much, much more bullish on this. You can see here, this analyst sees an $800 price on this, 43% upside. I think NVIDIA may actually surprise a lot more people than I think and a lot of other people think, because it's such a critical business for the future. Not only is it focused on AI, it's also focused on 5G, it's also focused on self-driving, it's focused on all the metrics that are pushing us forward in society where all the big money and big bets are going to be. So this is definitely one you want to have some exposure to at some point. Maybe you buy in, you know, on the next pullback, maybe you buy in now and just average in over time. Either way, some exposure to NVIDIA is not a bad idea. In terms of what analysts here have to say with their revenue targets, we can see 32% growth this year, 11% next year. Now, this is kind of a big difference, right? 32% this year with $22 billion, and then that's going to slow down to near $25 billion next year with 11%. I think NVIDIA is going to hold its ground. Probably going to see mid to high teens in the stock for growth. I think this is going to be a monster long term. I wouldn't be surprised to see $50-100 billion plus in revenue over the very long term. So this is kind of one of those stocks where it's like set and forget. They have a phenomenal balance sheet. They're extremely profitable, growing very nicely. All the metrics check off here. They're in semiconductor space, which is something critical for future. And guys, one of my favorite businesses out there. And the last one, let's touch on Salesforce, okay? Because this one, a little bit different from the others because there's a lot more going on with the business intricacies, which has pushed this stock lower and has presented honestly with a gift of a buying opportunity, and I am not missing out. Those in my VIP group know I have been buying Salesforce so heavy in recent months. It's crazy. It's become one of my largest positions, and I think I'm going to keep buying at these prices as well. This stock hit nearly $300 per share in September, okay? And then a few things started happening. You know, people were questioning cloud stocks. People were questioning what the future of this business is like. Then they announced a Slack acquisition. It's like, oh my gosh, they're going to take on a whole bunch of debt for this. All this negative news cycle came in. Investors bought into that. They sold the stock and it's pushed it down to around the $200 mark. It's a massive, massive correction. You can see here from its highs to the low point just a few weeks ago, this stock was down nearly 30%. But I think guys, we've bottomed in this. I think this one's going to start moving higher very soon. You can see we're still trying to struggle to break past these moving averages. But once we do, we're probably going to come retest around the 250 mark. And if that clears, probably clear skies ahead. We're probably going to make a run for all-time highs. That $300 mark doesn't seem that far-fetched. Now, I've said this many, many times. This is a $200 billion company today. This can be a half a trillion, $500 billion market cap company in a few years. That's more than a double up. And I think that is definitely my outlook when it comes to Salesforce. In terms of what analysts have to say, they're a lot more bullish on this than some of the other big techs just because it's been so suppressed. 25% upside or so, 274 price target. I think that's sandbagging it. Some of the more bullish analysts see around 315, 300, 285, 295. So I would say I'm more on the camp where it's the high 200s or maybe even $300 per share. By the end of this year, by the end of next year, we could be pushing somewhere in the low 300s, maybe mid 300s. But regardless, very, very bullish on this long term. And let's kind of look here to see what their revenues are going to be like in terms of growth. 21% expected this year, close to 19% next year, probably going to hit 20%, guys. And this is thanks to their core business growing, the shift to online work, and their recent acquisition with Slack, which hopefully should close very soon, sometime in this quarter or so. And that's just going to make this company so much more versatile. Maybe they do a push into consumers at some point because they're purely enterprise right now. And if that happens, oh man, that's going to open this up to be another Microsoft type stock with a trillion plus dollar market cap. And I am excited for their future. So again, guys, I've been buying Facebook, Amazon, Salesforce recently. These are the three big tech names that I absolutely love right now. Facebook, I may start slowing down on that because I have it as one of my largest positions. But Amazon and Salesforce, I still think there's so much more upside, guys. I can't stress that enough. So let me know in the comments, what are you doing with big tech? Are you selling them? Are you buying more? Are you holding? Do you feel that the upside is limited here? Love to hear all your thoughts and comments in the comment section down below, guys. But either way, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to invest positively, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.